Morning children, in today's class we'll see about the wastewater treatment that we can do in home or in the school laboratories. Okay, how the treatment is done outside in the treatment plants we can understand by this simple sample experiment. Okay, let's start how to do this wastewater treatment. So the wastewater that is being collected should be taken into a glass jar. Okay, I'll tell you how it is by drawing the picture and explain you through this. Okay children, let's start. See here children, this is a glass jar. What is this children? This is a glass jar. You are filling the 3/4 of the jar with water. What are you doing children? You are filling the 3/4 of the jar with water. Okay, 3/4 of water of jar, sorry, 3/4 of jar filled with water. Next, you are taking grass. You are taking the grass, detergent, oil, that is the orange peel, or the organic matter that is present in your kitchen. You can take any of the peels, that is used up peels for the food, isn't it? That you can take, and few drops of ink you should add into the water. What are you adding children? Once again I repeat, fill the glass jar with 3/4 of water and add some all the organic matter which makes the water dirty. Okay, 3/4 of water is filled in the jar, and in the jar you add this matter so that it becomes dirty. Dirty organic matter you are been adding into the jar. So why are you doing this experiment? You are doing this experiment to treat the sewage water. This is sewage water treatment. What are you doing children now? You are doing treatment of sewage water at home or in the school. Okay, so here after filling this with the 3/4 of water, you should cap the jar. This is the cap of the jar. Cap of jar. You put the lid or the lid over the jar and keep it aside. Okay, you mix the mixture of all these components in this water. You mix it and let it be stand for 2 days. Let it stand for 2 days. Okay, in the sunlight. In the sunlight, you have to keep it aside for 2 days. Let it stand for 2 days. You mix it, mix carefully all the ingredients that we have taken. That is, this as organic matter. It comprises the organic matter which dissolves in the water, and it is kept in the sunlight for 2 days. After 2 days, shake the mixture and pour a small sample in a test tube. Okay, so you are after 2 days. Next you have to do this experiment. I will tell you what to do after 2 days. Let's see after 2 days what happens. This is the mixture, and after 2 days you are taking a test tube. You are taking a sample of this water after 2 days. Okay children, so this is the treatment, before treatment. This is the sample 1. Label it as sample 1. Did you understand now all of you? So first, before treatment, after 2 days, you are taking a sample of this water into a test tube and marking it as sample 1. Okay, so you can know that by next you have to use an aerator, okay, for an, which you use in the apparatus, you have to take an aerator and stir it completely. Okay, so use the aerator next and stir the water that is present in the glass jar using the aerator. So this is the rod like structure which is called as the aerator, which is used to stir the substances present inside it. Okay, so that after the aeration process, after 2 days, after the aeration process, you have to keep it for several hours aside. Okay, after aeration, allow several hours for aeration. Then leave the aerator attached overnight completely to the jar itself. Then leave the aerator. If you do not have it, you can use any stirrer or a mixer. Okay, so if there is no aerator, you can also use the stirrer or a mixture to stir the substances. Stirrer or mixer to stir the substances in the jar to allow for aeration process. During aeration process, what happens, children? During aeration process, the microorganisms that they decompose the waste material present in the jar. So you take after aeration, after keeping this aerator, you keep this solution for several hours and take a sample after aeration into the test tube. This is after aeration. After aeration. This is sample 2. First you observe sample 1, whether you have the smell or not. So you find after 2 days keeping the waste material in the water, you find it a bad smell from it because it is completely closed for 2 days, and when you open the lid itself, foul smell comes out of the sewage water, forms the sewage water. So you took that sample in the sample 1. Later in sample 2, you have made the aerobic bacteria to act over this waste water so that they decompose the waste material that is present in that water. So a little bit difference can you see in the color of the substance and the smell of the substance, water also. So smell decreases a little due to the action of the aerobic bacteria. That is called as the biological process. So this is the biological process that took place. Okay, children. Next, you have to take a comb with the, you know, the, this is the tissue paper. You can make the comb with the tissue paper. Okay, children, with tissue paper you have to make a comb and add the, what you can say, that it is a sand, gravel, everything. If you add to it, you can, it acts as a filter. Okay, so you take a beaker several times. You have to, after aeration process, you have to filter this. You have to filter this into the beaker. All this liquid, that is the sewage water that is being used for after aeration, you have to take a filter paper and filter into the, through the funnel, attach it to the stand or anything. You can add this gravel, sand is added into the, is put into the filter paper which filters this water. So you filter it into the beaker. Several beakers you can take to filter if it is not sufficient. Okay, completely all the water you filter. Filter the water several times. Also several times you have to filter. So this you filter. Again this water you take in another beaker and filter several times so that no impurities are present here inside it. So this is the physical process to remove the impurities. This is the physical process of removing the impurities. Later into the beaker, after when you get the filtrate which is very clear, to observe, you take it and add certain chlorine tablets to it. What you are adding, children? Chlorine tablets. So that the remaining any foul smell in the water also will be cleared and you get a water which is completely treated. So this is the chemical process. Yes. This is the chemical process. So here, this wastewater treatment or the sewage water treatment involves biological process, physical process and also the chemical process in its treatment. Okay, hope you have understood, children. Once again, I'll explain you in sewage water treatment as we have done in the treatment plants. How they are treating the water in treatment plants, we can understand with this simple experiment, that which we can do in your houses or in the school laboratories. You are taking a glass jar with the 3/4 of water in it and adding the waste organic matter like grass, orange or any other peels that you have in the kitchen, and you can organic matter, that is made detergent, any detergent. Detergent and few drops of ink. You add to make it a water which is a dirty water, to make the water into a dirty one. Then you remain it for 2 days in the sunlight. Then let it stand in the sunlight. After 2 days, you take it and mark the sample one before treatment, which is taken after 2 days. Then you treat it with the aeration process, where the aerator is used, or a stirrer is used, or a mixer also can be used. You, after the aeration, you take this as a sample 2. Then, you in the sample 3, you can take after filtration process, that is the physical process. After the aeration, you use the filtration process and take the sample in the another test tube after the physical treatment of this water. This is known as sample 3. Okay, children. Next, coming to the chemical process, then you take that water after the chemical process by adding the chlorine tablet in the filtered water completely, and it forms the sample 4. Now you observe all the samples and you get the clarity that the before treatment how it was and after treatment how it was. After okay, children. So this is how the sewage water is treated completely. So this is the sewage water treatment. Hope you have understood, children. This is about the sewage water treatment that we do. Here are the questions for you, children, in your textbook in page number 133, and you can easily write the answers for these questions, where they have asked you, observe carefully the samples in all the test tubes. Test tube 1, test tube 2, test tube 3 and test tube 4, and they ask, do not taste and do not smell them. Anyway, this is a dirty water, you should not taste it, or you should not smell, just sorry, you should not taste, or just you have to smell it, you have to find the change in it. Okay, what changes did you observe in the appearance of water after aeration? So after aeration, a little bit of foul smell have been reduced, but there will be foul smell. But a little bit of aeration, the foul smell will be reduced after aeration because of the action of the aerobic bacteria. That is, that bacteria decompose the waste material by the aeration process. Next question asked here is, did aeration change the odor? Completely, it may not change the odor, but the change has been taken place. So you can write, yes, the aeration has changed the odor. What was removed by the sand filter? Here in the filter paper, we have used sand, gravel, isn't it? So fine gravel you have used for the filtration process here. So sand you have used, fine gravel, and while you filtering through the funnel, in the filter paper you use these for filtering the liquid that is being aeration. After aeration, you filter it in a beakers, and then the water is taken in the as a third sample in a test chamber. So that will be cleared with the, after several filtration processes, it will be cleared with the waste materials, isn't it? And filtration removes all the small particles that are present, waste particles that are present inside the water. Next, by adding the chlorine, so what was removed by sand filter? All the particles which are large particles can be removed, fine and large particles can be removed through the filter paper. By adding chlorine, what change do you observe? Within 3 and 4 samples, by adding chlorine, in third sample, the chlorine tablet is not added, still more some impurities will be present, which can be clarified by adding the chlorine tablet. So it can be disinfected from the various disinfected bacteria or the harmful organisms that are present still in the water can be purified by using the chlorine tablet. That is the chemical process that is being done in this process. So next, was it worse than that of the wastewater? No. No, it was not so worse. Write 2 points of each of similarities and differences between the process involved in treatment plant and this experiment. So in this experiment and wastewater treatment experiment, first, all the processes are involved. These are the similarities. There is a physical process, biological process, and also chemical process in the wastewater treatment plant also. Whereas in the waste treatment plant, there is a difference that here the involvement of the process takes place, the physical treatment takes place first, then the biological treatment, then the chemical treatment takes place in the wastewater treatment plants. Here, aerobic bacteria is being decomposed. There also the aerobic bacteria is being decomposed. The bacteria decomposes the waste material. Aerobic bacteria decomposes the waste material both in the treatment plants and also in the experiment that we have done in this process too. Whereas in the wastewater treatment plant, we get the biogas that is used for the production of electricity through the action of the anaerobic bacteria, that is the sludge and all that is being removed in the wastewater treatment plant. Here we are not using the sludge or any oil to remove the grease. So here you can remove the grease, if so, to by using the skimmers also. Skimmer can be used here, but it cannot be done completely in the laboratories, as in case of the that is treatment, the plants can do it clearly. That is the main difference that happens, and there the physical process first takes place, then the biological process, and at last the chemical process as such in both the cases. That is the difference and similarities that we find in wastewater treatment plant and also the experiment that we follow in the school laboratories. And next, what is the use of bar screen at sewage water treatment plant? Was anything like that present in this experiment? Yes, bar screen. Here, there is no such type of bar screen seen here, isn't it? Here only the filtration process takes place through the filter paper. Okay, so there, there grit and sand mold tank suits the filter paper here, where it removes the fine granules and all. But there the bar screen removes the large objects like the, you can say the, what are they called as, sticks, rags, polythene covers, everything. Here we do not use it, and also if you use also, they can be removed through the filter paper itself, or you can remove with the help of the hand too. Okay, so this is the difference and similarities between the in the wastewater treatment plant that carried out in the treatment plants and in the school lab. Hope you have understood this, children. And next, we'll continue with the diseases that are caused with the untreated water. So many diseases will be caused with the untreated water if they are discharged into the free-flowing water bodies. When they are consumed by the people, they suffer from various bacterial viral diseases, which they suffer a lot. Okay, diarrhea, tuberculosis, typhoid, especially the waterborne diseases like diarrhea, malaria, typhoid, cholera are being caused. Dysentery, cholera, dysentery, these are diarrhea are caused by this. Okay, children, hope you have understood this, and in the next class I will continue. Okay, children, so this is about the diseases that are caused with the consuming the waste water. We should not use the waste water, sewage water. If it is mixed with the good, that is the groundwater, it pollutes the water and causes many diseases. Thank you, children. In next class, I'll continue. Hope you have understood this. Learn well. Okay? Thank you.